wasn't until just a few years ago that I decided that I wanted to actually do something new. And I've always kept my technology and my art separate, and this is sort of the combination of the two. I actually recently wrote a blog post about how it was a professor of mine in art school that said, well, why don't you combine the two? Because I always kept them separate. But he said, why not? And I was like, he's right, why not? There's no reason to not do it. So this is for it. So the idea here is it makes art accessible. So let's say you would like to put a piece of your own work in your house, your office, your Boys and Girls Club, wherever. Let's say you have a color scheme in mind. Let's say you want it to be blue, right? So I can sit down with you. We can say, okay, I would like it to be blue. I'd like it to be medium busy. Let's see what happens. I can sit here all day to do this. Every piece of it is generated is completely 100% unique. And you can print this in any size you like. There's some samples here, and they're on metal, they're on acrylic. This one is a metal photo paper mounted on metal. It's got a beautiful, the metal has a beautiful shine to it.
She's giving us a little
treat. Great. I can talk about it all night long. Yes. So the idea is we can sit here. Every piece that's generated is unique. There's no duplicate that could ever be created. So let's say this is the one you're in love with. You get it printed in a couple of days. You put it on your wall in any size you like. You want it, you a little one, tiny one, a big one. They're generated as vectors. So you can literally create it as big as a printer can make it. Thank you. So that's what speaks to you. Like, this is participate in making your own art.
And what's the name of the app?
Hacked Art.
Hacked Art.
Yes.
And what's your name?
Marina Yanovolsky.
And what's your website?
Hackedart.com.
Awesome. Wild and wise, new woman in my life. And she does a lot of work. Tell us quickly about your work with girls.
So a large portion of my proceeds also goes to a nonprofit that I founded called Coda of Miami. We focus on getting women engaged in technology and coding through art. Not just women, but girls. We try to get them early. We started our first annual event last year. It was wildly successful. We raised enough money to send a couple of girls to Miami-Dade County College with a full scholarship. Our goal is to make technology not seem so scary and make it feel like you can apply to any part of your life. You can create art. You can make beautiful things with technology. You can use it. It's my medium, and I'd like for it